Good evening to everyone. It's wonderful to see you on our Good Friday and see you here at First United Methodist Church for these meditations on the cross. I have a few words about tonight's service. We try, as we may, to keep it as simple as we can, which is why we're just on the front and back of a single sheet, but we also wanted to give you as much information as we could. There are three essential elements to the service tonight, and I want to ask you, as you prepare yourself in a few moments, to come into this place, to consider each of these elements. The first element is symbol. We need symbols in our life. It's hard for us to speak about things that matter without symbols. There are many symbols in this room. One of them we are just finishing our preparations on. The confirmands have helped us all week. Not only did they build this labyrinth, they placed these some 100 candles in it and have been lighting them for the past 20 minutes. There are other symbols. Pay attention to the symbols that you see. The next element of our service is the words that we bring into it. Each lesson is going to contain words from the book of John, one of the I Am statements, and you see that printed in your bulletin. And then paired with that, you will see a heading in bold. The first one says, On Giving. What will follow is a reading from Khalil Gibran's The Prophet that comes from that chapter that the heading indicates. It is in the juxtaposition of these words that we feel some new space in worship can be found around the crucifixion. So we encourage you to pay attention to the words. Some of them you'll be able to read. Some of them you only have your ears to help you with. And the final element tonight is that of song. From the opening voluntary to our hymns and to the final chorus that we will sing, song becomes an important element in how we gather around this mysterious and mighty moment in our faith. Following the voluntary, you will hear an introit. The words are, Saw ye my Savior and God. He died on Calvary to atone for you and me and to free us from sorrow's great load. At the end of the service, you'll hear the choir sing this song again. And on the final refrain, I will turn and I want to invite you all to sing with us. It might be hard to see me when I turn, so just pay attention. I think by that point, you should know this tune. It's a beautiful southern tune from our own hymnody. But by the time we get there, we invite you to sing with us. And that'll be our final statement of the service, after which we will depart in peace and in silence and anticipate our return on Sunday. With that, let us join our hearts and our spirits in this time of worship and contemplation. Let us pray together. Go not yet away from us. At noontide, you have been our twilight, and your youth has given us dreams to dream. No stranger are you among us, nor a guest, but our son and our dearly beloved. Much have we loved you, but speechless was our love, and with veils it has been veiled. Yet now it cries aloud unto you, and would stand revealed before you. And ever has it been that the love knows not its own depth until the hour of separation. We will glory in the cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, in whom is our salvation, our life, and our
resurrection. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever, and the bread that I give for the life of the world is my flesh. John 6:51. You give but little when you give of your possessions. It is when you give of yourself that you truly give. For what are your possessions but things you keep and guard for fear you may need them tomorrow and tomorrow? What shall tomorrow bring to the over-prudent dog burying bones in the trackless sand as he follows the pilgrims to the holy city? And what is fear of need but need itself? Is not dread of thirst when your well is full, the thirst that is unquenchable? It is well to give when asked, but it is better to give unasked through understanding. And to the open-handed, the search for one who shall receive is joy greater than giving. And is there aught you would withhold? All you have shall someday be given.
Thank you.
Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. John 8:12. Your joy is your sorrow unmasked. And the self-same well from which your laughter rises was oftentimes filled with your tears. And how else can it be? The deeper that sorrow carves into your being, the more joy you can contain. When you are joyous, look deep into your heart and you shall find it is only that which has given you sorrow that is giving you joy. And when you are sorrowful, look again in your heart and you shall see that in truth you are weeping for that which has been your delight. Some of you say, joy is greater than sorrow. And others say, nay, sorrow is greater. But I say unto you, they are inseparable. Together they come, and when one sits alone with you at your board, remember that the other is asleep upon your bed. I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. John 15, 1. Oftentimes have I heard you speak of one who commits a wrong as though he were not one of you, but a stranger unto you, and an intruder upon your world. But I say that even as the holy and the righteous cannot rise beyond the highest which is in each of you, so the wicked and the weak cannot fall lower than the lowest, which is also in you. As a single leaf turns not yellow, but with the silent knowledge of the whole tree, so the wrongdoer cannot do wrong without the hidden will of you all. You are the way and the wayfarers. And when one of you falls down, he falls for those behind him a caution against the stumbling stone. Aye, and he falls for those ahead of him who, though faster and surer of foot, yet removed not the stumbling stone. And this also, though the word lie heavy upon your hearts, the murdered is not unaccountable for his own murder, and the robbed is not blameless in being robbed. The righteous is not innocent of the deeds of the wicked, and the white-handed is not clean in the doings of the felon. Yea, the guilty is oftentimes the victim of the injured, and still more often, the condemned is the burden bearer for the guiltless and unblamed. You cannot separate the just from the unjust and the good from the wicked, for they stand together before the face of the sun, even as the black thread and the white are woven together. And when the black thread breaks, the weaver shall look into the whole cloth, and he shall examine the loom also.
Thank you.
I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. John 14:6. Say not, I have found the truth, but rather, I have found a truth. Say not, I have found the path of the soul. Say rather, I have met the soul walking upon my path. For the soul walks upon all paths. The soul walks not upon a line, neither does it grow like a reed. The soul unfolds itself like a lotus of countless petals.
Thank you.
I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for his sheep. When you love, you should not say, God is in my heart, but rather, I am in the heart of God. And think not you can direct the course of love, for love, if it finds you worthy, directs your course. Love has no other desire but to fulfill itself. But if you love and must needs have desires, let these be your desires: to melt and to be like a running brook that sings its melody to the night, to know the pain of too much tenderness, to be wounded by your own understanding of love, and to bleed willingly and joyfully. To wake at dawn with a winged heart and give thanks for another day of loving. To rest at the noon hour and meditate love's ecstasy. To return home at eventide with gratitude. And then to sleep with a prayer for the beloved in your heart and a song of praise upon your lips.
Thank you.
Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live and never die. Do you believe this? John 11, 25 and 26. You would know the secret of death. But how shall you find it unless you seek it in the heart of life? The owl whose night-bound eyes are blind unto the day cannot unveil the mystery of light. If you would indeed behold the spirit of death, open your heart wide unto the body of life. For life and death are one, even as the river and the sea are one. In the depth of your hopes and desires lies your silent knowledge of the beyond. And like seeds dreaming beneath the snow, your heart dreams of spring. Trust the dreams, for in them is hidden the gate to eternity. Your fear of death is but the trembling of the shepherd when he stands before the king, whose hand is to be laid upon him in honor. Is the shepherd not joyful beneath his trembling that he shall wear the mark of the king? Yet is he not more mindful of his trembling? For what is it to die but to stand naked in the wind and to melt into the sun? And what is it to cease breathing but to free the breath from its restless tides that it may rise and expand and seek God unencumbered? Only when you drink from the river of silence shall you indeed sing. And when you have reached the mountaintop, then you shall begin to climb. And when the earth shall claim your limbs, then shall you truly dance.